So good afternoon, everybody. So I will in this presentation introduce a little bit what is happening in France on bioeconomy, and would like to start with what we understand bioeconomy is. So bioeconomy is a sustainable production of biomass, agricultural or wood or marine biomass, and it's a transformation for food, energy, chemistry, and materials. So that's the definition that we have in France. We have recognized in France as being the definition of bioeconomy. Sorry. So the various products of the bioeconomy, again, food, bio-based material, bio-based molecules, bioenergy, and also environmental services through energy by processing waste, and also through carbon storage in ground. What are the challenges for the bioeconomy? The challenge is that it's new opportunities for agricultural and forestry producers, a value creation logic, and ecological transition. This, we talk a lot on climate change, carbon storage, and so forth. A creation of non-delocatable jobs in the country, and specifically in rural area, and an independence regarding certain independence regarding imports of fossil fuels. In numbers, what does it mean for the bioeconomy today? On the French territory, bioeconomy is 1.9 million jobs. It's nowadays approximately 11% of chemicals. It's a turnover of 300 billion of euro. And it is in the renewable energy portfolio. It's 50% of the production of renewable energy. So we understand that it's a wide variety of sectors. So around that, France decided to set up a strategy for the bioeconomy. This strategy has been approved in Conseil des ministres, ministry councils, in January 2017. It has been officially published during the agriculture exhibition in Paris in February 2017. This strategy is based on a work interministerial group, including the Ministry of Agriculture, Ministry of Industry, and Ministry of Environment. Also, research and innovation, which is not on this slide, ministry was also involved. It has been 18 months collaborative work with all these stakeholders, and it has been supported by the French presidency at that time. See Mr. Hollande here on the picture. And it has been declined in an action plan for the first period, 2018-2020. So what are the priorities of this strategy? First one is to ensure that bioeconomy products become a market reality. Second one is to support the transition to effective, innovative, and sustainable bio-based industry. Then to secure the sustainable production of renewable resources to answer all needs, ensuring a sustainable bioeconomy, building dialogue with society for a unitedly shared bioeconomy, this means a strong communication action, and supporting innovation for a high performance bioeconomy. These priorities are national priorities. It has been declined in some regions of France, almost two at minimum. The first one is Grand Est Région. The Grand Est Région has make for bioeconomy as one of its top priority for its territorial development, and has set up, has organized some general state for bioeconomy in June 2018, and has voted a bioeconomy plan in October 17 this year. This bioeconomy plan giving some priorities for the development of the sector. In this framework, we have with IR organized. We have organized the first symposium, and we are part of the management of this plan, this action plan. In Hauts-de-France, which is a neighbor area, the bioeconomy convention took place in April 2018, and the master plan has been published in September 2018. So this means all the two regions have now all the tools to develop this bioeconomy. And in this environment, the competitiveness cluster IAR is a tool to further develop the system. And we focus our action on facilitating project developments, being a research and development project, but also industrial project on the area. Since the liberalization of this cluster in 2005, we have set up 300 projects were developed in innovation and industrialization. This bring up a total investment of 1.8 billion euro, of which approx 600 million euro of public funding and 1.2 billion euro on private funding. Around the cluster, we have 400 members. This members covers also the size of companies, being from the startup or SME up to big industrial groups, and include all the value chain of the bioeconomy, that is to say, from production, agricultural or forestry production, up to final usage of the product, like chemistry, chemicals in the companies, but also cosmetic company and pharmaceutical company. So all this value chain is covered by our 400 members. In the action plan for the French bioeconomy in France, we have one specific action, which is the creation of the agro-bio-based in the showcase of bioproducts to bring a guide for industry or for people to choose some product coming from biomass and use alternative to petrochemical products. This agro-bio-based has nowadays 400 products, 150 suppliers are in the agro-bio-based, and we have 36,000 connections per year on this site, on this website, and a lot of business is coming in. So outside of that, IAR has set up a complete ecosystem for innovation in the two regions. This ecosystem of innovation has been allowed by the dynamism of some stakeholders or private company in order to give to the to the ecosystem the tools to promote research program and also to go to industrialization. So on this ecosystem, you will see that we cover a lot of sector of the bioeconomy. One of those is biofuels. We have two projects hosted in the territory, One is the one is Beautifuel here, which is a project to produce lignocellulosic biofuels by gasification of biomass and further production of liquid. We have another project which is Procetol2G, which is to produce ethanol by biotechnology from lignocellulosic biomass. So this means two alternatives for the biofuels. Then we have all what is linked to protein with improve here. And we have also all what is improve is an open platform for protein research, which is led by industry and also by CNRS. And we have also in front of improve some projects for extraction or purification of component out of biomass with extractives here. And also in Pomac we have in Pomac here we have a company for biotechnology, white biotech and also industry. And we have also all what is linked to materials with hemp European cluster here. The area is a strong hemp producer, and from hemp we developed components for automotive or transportation as a general rule. Hemp fiber being lighter than glass fiber and allowing a lower weight for the transportation means. This means a saving in energy. So all of that, all these clusters also covers what is linked to the development of more sustainable agriculture with an initiative here which is Terra Lab, which makes some experiments with new agronomic pathway, and also another one in the other part of the cluster, which is a network of farms in Picardy. So all that, all this innovation cluster ecosystem allow to bring to the innovating companies tools to go further for the development. Some example of new initiative coming out on the top of that. First, a new initiative is linked to the speeding up of the development of new process by startup or SMEs to allow them to go faster on the market. This project is a so-called Alpha project. It's in the Grand Est. And it is led by a company called ARD. And the target is to help through reimbursable funding the scaling up of process on some demonstration facilities. So the area targeted are industrial, marine, agricultural biotech, plant extraction, pretreatment of cellulosic biomass, and also green chemistry. The partners outside of ARD are our cluster IR, Gandinov, which is a Grand Est Innovation Platform, Semia, which is a funding, Scalinov, and Demeter, which is a venture capital. Then we have in Hauts-de-France a project which is so-called Farming. Farming is to build the first fully automated industrial plant to produce insect protein by a startup which is so called Insect. Insect is a company, which has got some financing from European Commission through BBI, Bio-based Industry, to scale up and to build their first industrial plant. Then we have we were talking about hydrogen. there is a large project which is so-called Vitrihydrogen to develop production of hydrogen from renewable biomass in this part of in Vitry, Le François. This project is subsidized by ADEME at a level of 5.4 million euros and is also led by a small company, SME, so-called Hafnir Energy. And at the end, a new initiative is linked to protein, plant protein. We have many projects around plant protein, and we establish with some partners a cluster which is so-called Protein France that we manage as IR. And this cluster includes a lot of actors of protein in order to promote the usage of plant-based protein in food. At the end, we are outside of being active in France and in a region Grand Est and Haut de France. We are active in Europe. We have a strong involvement in BBI, bio-based industry, which is a joint undertaking initiative within the frame of Horizon 2020. We are member of the board. We are also founder of a father member of BIC, Bioindustry Consortium. We are also member, of course, of Europa Bio, and we have some links with the European Commission to send some position paper on bioeconomy. We have a review we have put some position paper in order to bring our ideas for the European bioeconomy strategy review, which has take place in 2018. And we lead an intercluster, European intercluster in Europe, which is 3BI, which include bioeconomy cluster in Germany, BioVail in UK, and BioBase Delta in Belgium. So these are a little bit what we do for the promotion of the bioeconomy in France and abroad with through the cluster. And I am at your disposal if you have any question. Thank you.
Many thanks for this very nice presentation. I have some question about the economic models, because I think that right now the products which are bio-based compared to fossil fuel-based are much expensive. In particular, if we think to fuel, hydrogen, and everything. So I would like to know if you first could give us maybe numbers about the difference of price between this bioeconomy and the fossil fuel economy, and maybe tell us what would be the price of the carbon tax which would be required so that economically these bio-based products are more less expensive than the fossil fuel-based ones.
So. It's a very interesting question. I will try to summarize a little bit in my reply. First thing is that it's obvious that bioeconomy nowadays cannot compete with bulk chemicals. No way, in no way. So this means that the main developments of bioeconomy products are in specialty chemicals or in fine chemicals. This means where the value added is high enough in order to support some cost price which may be higher. We are not bringing me too of existing products, we are bringing some products with some differentiation in terms of properties and so on, in order to bring a certain service and value to the customers, which is ready to pay. So that's as a general rule. The main developments that we have are in the range of cosmetic ingredients, cosmetic actives, surfactants, some kind of surfactants, not all, organic acids, polyester with certain properties and so on. As far as biofuel is concerned, the bioethanol nowadays and the biofuel as a general rule do exist because of tax reduction on for the customer. This does not mean that it is tax negative for the state. When you produce some in industry, when you produce, you pay a lot of tax. So your products include this price, include this tax. So the tax is paid to the state. In parallel of that, there is a reduction of what we call tax on petroleum products. This reduction is a compensation. In other words, if there is no biofuel, there is this tax. If this tax do exist for the petroleum origin products, but if there is biofuel, this tax does not exist on this hand, but it does exist on the production of the biofuel. So for the states, it's equal in terms of income of tax, but for the competitiveness of the product, it's better.
And is it possible just to have kind of numbers on that? Yes.
You were asking of break-even, I would say, price of the fossil carbon as compared to renewable carbon for the competitiveness. We did calculate that, of course, everything is coupled. You cannot decouple the price of corn or wheat or sugar with the cost of energy. But even so, we calculate that we have a break-even point that's in the range of $70 a barrel. That's higher than $70 a barrel, the renewable carbon becomes attractive.
Many thanks.
And so sustainability has three pillars: environment, social, and economic. So it's related to these three pillars. So bioeconomy, as a general rule, is creating value on territories. This means job. This is for the social and economic way. And the third thing is that we have a lot of programs for a more sustainable production of biomass through a research, development, and innovation program linked to new agronomic pathway. We were talking earlier today on crop cover. That is something which is nowadays developed a lot in this area. And the second thing is that we test and we are promoting the use of what we call bio-intrant for the agriculture, biocontrol. We are part of the consortium, French consortium for biocontrol. And nowadays we have some products which are coming on the market. And we work also on stimulations and biofertilizers in order to allow a quicker and higher penetration of mineral fertilizers, phosphate and so on in the plants thanks to bacteria.
Yes, I just like to stress what has just been said on biocontrol and biostimulation. We have not heard a lot about that today, but I think it can be a real revolution in agriculture and in the use of pesticides and fertilizers in the future, and all the emissions linked to these products. The principle is to use microorganisms or natural substances for agriculture.
Yeah, thank you for your presentation. I work to make fine chemicals, so perhaps I will shoot my own feet saying that. But talking about sustainability is asking myself, do we have to select for what we use resources? We say it has to be sustainable because we do bioconversion, but for example, cosmetics. Do we have to invest in, because resources are limited. We take some carbon and everything from the soil to make something not necessary for living. So do we have to balance the flux? Because many flux of biotechnology, many money is going to fine chemicals such as cosmetic, because it's high value-added products. So they don't, this money don't go to other projects that are less value-added. So how we deal with that?
So what kind of money do you think about, do you speak about? This money doesn't go to
Many subvention, I think, on development and okay. New cosmetics molecule and things like that.
So there is not a lot of incentive or subvention, as you say, on development of cosmetic products. It's a development which is made with private, likely private money. Then, as far as cosmetic is concerned, it's of course one of the output of the bioeconomy, but it's not the big amount. I was giving that as an example of high value-added products, and even though it substitutes products which are produced with fossil carbon or with some other process at the end of the day. So I'm not sure if I catch properly your question, but these cosmetic products are, whatever it is, are consumed and we replace one consumption, one type of consumption by another. Then as far as the efforts on less valuable products are concerned, the big research and development and innovation effort nowadays are linked to all what is we said on bioentrant, biocontrol and biofertilizers, which mobilize a lot of money. We also have a strong research on protein, and when we talk about protein, we don't talk only on I will say functionalized protein for protein ingredient, but also in agronomy for seed selection in order to have some protein production in substitution of importation, for instance, of soya protein out of Brazil. So it's a lot of work that is done nowadays in order to bring this alternative in the agronomic pathway of the farmers, specifically in the coverage of the ground all the year long, you have the possibility to put some proteaginous plants on the ground in order to increase the value for the farmers, but also to have several advantages. One of those is to produce protein. The second is to bring protein back down to the ground. And the third is that by doing so, you don't need to have several treatments, pesticide treatments afterward for the next crop. So it's this third advantage. So I have no fundamentally any reply on that, I'm sorry, but what I know a little bit is alfalfa protein could be more or less like grass protein. Alfalfa is a real part of the production, agricultural production of this area on the rotation. There is alfalfa which covers approximately 7 to 10% of the ground in the Champagne-Ardenne area. And so these alfalfa proteins are then, of course, dried in order to be used for feed and more recently for food, because we got a novel food agreement for protein extract, which bring to bring an interesting spectrum of amino acid for kids, for instance.